Hello and welcome. Today we're going to be making perfect breakfast tacos and we're going to pair it with a breakfast salsa. For this recipe, you're going to need some pre-warmed corn tortillas. Chorizo. Amigos, sometimes your chorizo will come with the casing and that's okay. It just keeps your chorizo nice and moist and also preserves the flavor. So just squeeze it out just like that. Eggs. Heavy whipping cream, baking powder, salt, Mexican cheese blend, all-purpose flour. In this bowl, I have grated potatoes soaked in water and 1 tablespoon of baking soda. Allow that to soak for 5 minutes and then strain and dry. For our breakfast salsa, you're gonna need serranos, chile de árbol, key lime, garlic, tomatillos, onions, tomatoes, cilantro, salt, Mexican oregano, and a little bit of water. To your grated potatoes, add your all-purpose flour. You want to make sure to coat them evenly to where they look like shredded mozzarella, and any excess flour can just fall to the bottom, so that's why I used our strainer just like that. Heavy whipping cream, baking powder, and beat it,
because nobody wants to be defeated at breakfast time.
That's right. And once they're well combined, set them to the side. To your pot, you want to add your water, and you want to add all of your salsa ingredients except your lemon, cilantro, salt, and Mexican oregano. What the water is going to do is going to help cook our ingredients, making them nice and soft while also getting that char that we love for our breakfast salsa. I'm going to set this to the side and allow it to happen for about 8 to 10 minutes. Do you know what that means, Cloud?
We're ready to fry.
That's right. We are ready to fry. Remember, if you're going to test your oil, make sure that it's an uncoated wooden spoon, wooden chopstick, some toothpicks, and when it bubbles like that, that means we're ready to go. Place your potatoes gently in the oil and allow them to fry. Yummy. Ooh, that made me really happy. And now we're gonna fry in 2 batches until they're nice and crispy. Make sure not to add all of them at one time unless you have a huge pot, just so that we can get an even crisp for our potatoes. Give or take, after 3 to 4 minutes, you're gonna get them nice and crisp, and you wanna take them out when they turn a golden crispy brown, okay? I like to place them in a little basket just so that the oil drips, and what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna sprinkle a little bit of salt over the top and I'm gonna continue with our next batch. And before I start our second batch, I'm just gonna run through our oil with our skimmer to remove any excess flour or any of the little crispy bits that just broke off, so it doesn't burn our oil and we get a beautiful golden fry.
And they don't pop on my face.
That too. It's been about 4 minutes, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna remove the lid from our pot so that now all that water can evaporate and then we start getting that roast. So by the time we're done making our taquitos, this is gonna be fully roasted. Place your burner on a medium heat and add a little bit of oil. Add your chorizo and continue to cook for about 6 to 8 minutes. If you notice, I left the chorizo into bigger pieces, that way we get a good bite from our taquitos. Okay, once you've done that, you're gonna pour your eggs. Place your burner on a low temperature because we don't want stinky burned eggs. Take it easy on your eggs, everyone. Cuídense los huevitos. And we're just gonna move our eggs around gently until they're fully cooked. And boom, done. We're ready to fill our taquitos and blend our salsa. And now we're gonna blend until smooth on a 3. 1, 2, oh, 1, 2, 3. No me quisiste dar un one?
Oh, no, I was dancing. Okay. I'm a dancer.
And then they wonder, okay? And then they wonder why it happens like this. Friends, just blend. Ignore Cloud for a minute. And you know what happens when you're having a good time? You forget to add a few ingredients. Don't forget to blend this with your cilantro, salt, and Mexican oregano. And if you guys want, you can add the key lime. And boom, done. In this bowl, I have a mixture of all-purpose flour, a little bit of water, and this is what we're gonna use to seal our taquitos. Take a little bit of your glue and swipe it at the top. I hope you're impressed, Cloud. I just used my left hand.
I am impressed. I love your left hand.
Thank you. Shout out to all our lefties watching. We love you. Now we're just gonna roll. and set it to the side. I'm gonna continue with the remaining taquitos, and while I'm doing that, I'm gonna warm up my oil. Place your pan on a medium heat, and when your oil is nice and hot, you're gonna place your taquitos right on into that oil. Friends, last time we were frying, somebody put their hands in the oil. Do not do that. Don't be brave. Take it easy.
Who are we talking about?
One of our friends, one of the Views Club, put her, she was frying the quesadillas and she ended up putting her fingers in the oil. Yeah, be careful. I'm gonna start using these more often on here so that you guys aren't tempted to do wild things. So I want you guys to be very careful because I love you. It's holiday season and somebody always gets a burn. It happened to me last year with the oven, if you guys can see.
Well, they can do wild things, just not with oil.
Yeah, you can do wild things. It's right there.
Ouchie.
You see that?
Mm-hmm.
I'll just cover it up. I haven't decided if I'm going to get the cilantro tattoo on there or not.
If you get one, then I will not.
No, you know what my first tattoo will be.
Mm-hmm.
If I decide to get one, but I'm not in a rush.
You're not in a rush?
I'm not in a rush. Friends, we're going to continue to fry our taquitos until they're nice and crispy. I'll do like a minute on this side and then I'm gonna start turning it over just like this. And depending on your tortillas and the type of oil that you're using, you might get a little bit of a burn. So just, you know, look at your taquito, say, oh, this one needs to be turned just a bit, and then so on so forth. And boom, done. Our taquitos are almost ready. I just have a few more to go. And just take it easy. If you feel that your heat is too high and it's burning your taquitos, just lower your temperature. You're gonna be okay.
Not to tease you or ruin the fun, but I get to eat first today and every day. Thank you, sister.
You're welcome. Who's ready for a bite? I'm gonna need somebody very, very special to say
buen provecho.
This is a perfect breakfast taquito. You can taste the chorizo and the egg, and it's so fluffy inside. And what makes it even better is that the cheese melted on top of the taquito, adding that perfect consistency with your, well, what I did was I used a little sour cream and crema fresca, and wow, spectacular.
I felt the same way.
I love the added crunch too with the texture of the chorizo and egg.
The fried potato flakes. I was going more for hash browns, but it's absolutely perfect. You didn't have to go extra on the potatoes, but you can still taste them. And this is what dreams are made of, right? Some amazing food.
Good company.
Great company. And good friends. This has got to be the most perfect breakfast. So if you're having family over for the holidays, this is a really good one to make. That's so good.
It does deserve a slap.
It does.
Just don't slap anyone. Remember, hands are not for hitting.
Maybe on this occasion.
As always, Cloud and I are wishing you the best. We absolutely adore you. We hope that you're practicing your holiday recipes, and don't forget to follow us on our other social media. And on that one, we'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye. Adios.